What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to add user accounts in Starbound. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. In the universe of Starbound, other survivors who might find your IP address are guaranteed to pop up and attempt to thrive on your server. But in some cases, you might want to have a bit more control as to what these players are able to do. Luckily, Starbound allows you to create player accounts, which you can use to set admins or even whitelist players to pick who's able to join. With a unique username and password for each of your players, you can easily choose to limit the world to your closest friends, or you can even keep it to yourself, making it so no outside players can enter. Let's go over how to create these accounts. Head into your Apex server panel and stop the server. And after this, open the config files section in the left-hand menu, and then open server config until the text editor is available. Once you're inside of this editor, scroll down near the bottom and find the server users section. After this, replace username here with your desired username for the account, and replace password here with the password that you want the account to use. If you want the account to have admin privileges, make sure that the admin section is set to true. And once this is done, press the save button at the top and restart the server. In some cases, you might actually want to have multiple accounts created for your server, like one who does have admin privileges and one that does not. The process for this is similar, but instead you'll add all of your username and password options separated by a colon after the closing bracket. When you're done, it should look like this. Like before, after you edit the usernames, admin status, and passwords, press save and restart the server. While Starbound does not have the usual console-managed whitelist, you can prevent any anonymous connections from your server, meaning that users will have to have a user account in order to connect. In your server config editor, find Allow Anonymous Connections near the top of the page and make sure that it's set to false. Then you can press save and restart the server again. Now, next time you try to enter the server, you will have to fill out the username and password fields. Just enter the desired username and password and then connect normally. As long as your information is correct, you will join the server normally and you can begin playing on your new account. Now, let's go over some common issues. If the anonymous connections disallowed message pops up, it means that the whitelist has been enabled and you're trying to connect without a user account. When a user account was created in the server config file, you'll have to use that account to join a whitelisted server. If you do want accounts to be optional, just make sure that Allow Anonymous Connections is set to true in your config file and then restart. The No Such Account or Incorrect Password error will appear whenever incorrect information is entered or if there's no account created. Make sure that the username and password you are entering in-game match exactly what is typed in the config file. And if there's no user account made, all you have to do is leave these lines blank and you should be able to connect normally. Whether you make user accounts to choose who will have admin privileges, or if you make them so that no random players can join your server, this is a great way to make sure you have control over the privileges of the people who do play, since you can choose who to give the account information to. This account can also be changed at any time in your config files, so if you want to remove access from a certain player, it's easy to do. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.